Praise the Lord, praise the Lord, praise the Lord. God bless you all as you are worshiping me in the mighty name of Jesus. My name is Apostle Peter Daniel. Apostle Peter Daniel from Nigeria, Ondo State. By the special grace of God, you are in life with in Heaven and Air Live program, which we used to do every day from Monday to Saturday. From Monday to Saturday, we do Heaven and Air Live program from Monday to Saturday, 9 a.m. to 10 or 11 a.m. Nigeria time. And we also used to do Deliverance Hour. We call it Deliverance Hour, whereby you can be set free from every diverse causes you might have been working in your life, every demonic atmosphere, every power of the darkness, every satanic atmosphere in your life. You can destroy them and be smart to the work of the darkness in your life. In this, if you know you are passing through difficulties in your life, temptations, trials of the devils, whatsoever the kind of demonic attack you are under, this is a platform, it is a service whereby you will be set free by 9 p.m. Nigeria time to 10 or 11 p.m. That's how you do the prayer. And that one is every day. That one is Monday to Sunday, every day. And by the special grace of God, we used to have our special service every Saturday. That's where we worship God together with all the brethren around the world. We worship God together. By 10 a.m., we start the service. By 10 a.m., we start the service. Make sure you are here. And by the special grace of God, if you wanted to support this program, you can kindly speak to me. Because this program, Heaven and Air program, we need more of your support. Because the message needs to circulate the whole world. The whole world needs to hear it. So whatsoever, if you want to join those who are supporting us, you can kindly WhatsApp me on +234 81 389 66 287. Come again, +234 81 389 66 287. That is my WhatsApp number or call number. By the special grace of God Almighty, we are going to the Word of God now. To the Word of God now. Let's pray. Father, in Jesus' name. Father, in Jesus' name. Everlasting Savior, the Redeemer of all nations, the God who died for us and resurrected on the third day. We glorify your name. We give you all the praises, all the honor, all the adorations. We say thank you, Jesus, for the provision of your blood. Thank you, Jesus, for dying and coming back to life for us. Mentakrumbe la pakwa katikikando sihambaradoza. Mentepradoza hambarapato sekriatata. Melissa Cruz Sepeteria. Marapatos kibarabados yambalataz. In the name of Jesus, our everlasting Father, we ask you, Jesus, that you come into our life this morning and to lead us in whatsoever we want to do in the message of right now. We ask you, God, to speak to us, speak through us, speak to our ear, open our sight to see the things of the Spirit, open our ear to hear the things of the Spirit in the name of Jesus. Open our ears, open our eyes, open our brain to go deep in the things of the Spirit in the mighty name of Jesus. My Father, I pray that those who are hearing me, they are set free from every bondage of life, every bondage of the evil one in Jesus' name. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Amen. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. Once again, my name is Apostle Peter Daniel. You are in Heaven and Earth Life program. Today, we want to treat a very expensive topic. I will call it that. The expositions of the false prophet. And today, I'm going to mention some prophets that are walking in the higher realm of the darkness. I'm going to talk about the prophet, I mean the living one, those who are alive, that are walking in the realm of the higher demon. You are walking in the realm of this evil powers, occultic powers, satanic powers, evil powers, which you must not listen to them at all, nor even say prayer to their prayers. Say amen to their prayers. Or watch their TV, because when you watch them, there are powers that captured your heart and put your heart in bondage whenever you watch them. I'm going to mention their name today by God's grace. I will mention their name today by God's grace. And I will show them, I will show you the pictures which they carry. But before I go through the word of God, there are messages that the Bible scripture to back whatsoever message I want to give to you all. I want to give to you all. I want you to open your Bible to the book of Matthew. Open your Bible to the book of Matthew. Matthew. Book of Matthew, chapter 7, Matthew chapter 7, verses 15. Then listen to me, my everyone here, please, I beg you in the name of God. Beware of false prophet, which come to you in the sheep's clothing, but inward they are ravening wolves. Beware of false prophet. They come to you in the clothes of sheep, but inwardly they are ravening wolves. 16. Ye shall know them by their fruit. Do men gather grape of thorn, or fig of thistle? 17. Even so, every good tree bringeth forth good fruit, but a corrupt tree bringeth forth evil fruit. Verse 18. A good tree cannot bring forth evil tree, neither can a corrupt tree bring forth good fruit. Verse 19, every tree that bringeth not forth good tree is hacked down and cast into the fire. Malakrus and the prana goes the kaya kayaba. 20, wherefore by their fruits ye shall know them. 21, not everyone that says, say it unto me, Lord, Lord, shall enter into the kingdom of heaven, but he that doeth the will of my Father, which is in heaven. 22. Many will say to me in that day, Lord, Lord, have we not prophesied in your name? And in your name have cast out devils, and in your name done many wonderful works. Verse 23, and then will I profess unto them, I never knew you. Depart from me, ye that walketh iniquity. Malatus yandaba. Ye that walketh iniquity. So the Lord Jesus Christ, in those days, there's nothing like false prophet in the time of Jesus Christ, when the prophecy was coming out. That time it was, there were no false prophecy then. No. It was the only prophet that we have those days are Jesus, is Jesus and the John the Baptist. In the time Jesus spoke that message, it is only Jesus and the John the Baptist. That's the only prophet that was in that time. But Jesus began to say what is to come. The prophecy you just read is God is for us, is for what is to come. God, Jesus, has seen what is going to happen. So he has told them earlier. He said the prophet, false prophet shall come. He said that they will come in a way that we think, hey, this pastor, God is using him though. In fact, God is using her. In fact, she's a wonderful pastor. Now, and we believe that she is one of the sent, the servant of God that is anointed from above, because his prophecy will be accurate. His preacher, he will be preaching the Bible, but not the deep of the Bible. It will be preaching the surface of the Bible. It will be preaching what interests people. It will be preaching what makes the heart of people draw. It will be preaching money. It will be preaching prosperity. It will be preaching success. It will not preach a real deep holiness. It can even be preaching repentance. It can even be preaching repentance. But if you worship, it will not come against the things of the world. It will not come against the things of the sinful. It will only be preaching the surface message. These people are satanic people, the people that are sent from the pit of hell, the people that are possessed with the demons. They are possessed with demons. These people have went to Satan to go and bow down before. They have gone and bow down to Satan. They have sold their soul to the devil. And they have also sold every man, every woman looking at them to the devil. If they pray, the agreement between them and the Satan is this. Because if you say, now, if a man of God pray for you and you say amen, amen is if I define amen for you, you know that it's very powerful. Amen is a act of agreement and covenant. It's an act of agreement of saying whatsoever you are saying to me, I agree 100%. Amen means a act of entering into covenant. The meaning of amen truly is Jesus. The meaning of amen, the Bible says, amen, amen, blessings and glory. Now, the meaning of amen is Jesus Christ. But in the kingdom of the darkness, it is no more Jesus. Now, it is a demonic atmosphere. It is a demonic covenant. Covenant and agreement that when they are saying something, now when they are saying something and you say amen to their prayers and you say amen to their prayer, you enter into a deep covenant with them that will put you in their bondage. And that is why whenever the prophesies, you will always see them in your dream. It is not normal. You have already entered them. You say, sir, I see prophet this and that in my dream. All the dream you are seeing, as you are seeing the prophet, they have put you in bondage. They have put you in a captivity of darkness. You are already in prison because you have stepped into that touch, or because you have said amen to their prayers. That's why you have to be very careful. In fact, nowadays, now, they are no more saying amen now. It is I receive. It is what? I receive. They will say, when they pray, they will say, I receive. When they say you are going to be present, I receive. Do you know for I receive? I will tell you the minute later. Hallelujah. In the book of Matthew chapter 24, open your Bible. Matthew chapter 24, open your Bible. Matthew chapter 24. Matthew chapter 24. If you look at verses 11, Matthew chapter 24, verses 11, it said, and many false prophets shall rise and shall deceive many. And because iniquity shall abound, the love of many shall wax cold. You see that? Many false prophets shall arise in this last day. Many false prophets, they shall arise in this last day. How will you know them? I will explain it to you. Don't worry. Don't be too hurry. I will explain it to you. How will you know the false prophet? I will explain it to you. Yeah. If you look at Matthew 24, verse 24. He said, for there shall arise false Christ and false prophets, and shall show great signs and wonder. Eh? Great signs and wonders. Listen to this, oh. In so much that if it were possible, they shall deceive the very elect. You see that? That miracle will be so much that even the Christian will say, The only minister will get, The only Christian will say, I think this pastor is from God, oh. This has deceived the very elect. The Lord will bless us in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Now, I'm going to mention their names now. They are prophets that God told me that they are demonic pastors. They have operated, in fact, they don't have any fear of God at all in their life. Yeah. They don't have any fear of God in their life at all. They don't have fear of God in their life at all. Their conscience are be iron. Their conscience are be sealed. Eh? The Lord spoke to me about some prophet, and I'm going to mention them. Their heart has been sealed with the devil. They have dined and drink with the devil. They have drink and enter into serious covenant with the devil. I mean, the prophet that I wanted to mention their name. There is a prophet, the number one prophet I'm going to mention today. Number one prophet I'm going to mention today is Prophet Bushiru Shepherd. This prophet, Prophet Bushiru Shepherd. I know many of you know this prophet, right? You have been hearing from him. You know how miraculous, miracle things he used to do. He used to do miracle. He used to do miracle. He can prophesy. He even called himself Major One. Prophet Bushiru Shepherd. He called himself Major One. He deceived many with false miracles and false signs and wonders. I will tell you face to face that this pastor is a satanic pastor. By the special grace of God, God has sent me to expose many false preachers. And I will sell it even to their face. They are false prophets that you should not follow at all. When they pray for you and you say amen to their prayer, you are in trouble. When they pray for you and you say you receive, you have received them. When they pray for you and you claim the proud prayer, you have entered into a deep covenant of the darkness. This pastor is a demonic pastor. According to what God told me, he said he entered into a deep, deep sea. To most of them enter into the deep sea. To go and collect their power from the devil. from the marine water, from the marine spirit. They are not to be washed at all. He is also helping people. Don't collect help from him. Don't accept his help. They are devilish pastors. They are not a candidate of heaven. They are not a preacher of the world. In fact, according to what the Lord said to me, he did not know them at all. He has not even anointed them at all. I mean the same pastor. So you have to be very extremely careful of who you follow. Be very, very careful of who you what you follow. If you are not careful of who you follow, I'm so sorry for you. You might land in hell, because anybody that follow them will automatically enter hell. There's no way they are going to do it. They will enter hell. They will enter hell. You have to be very, very careful of who you follow. I repeat, be careful of who you follow. Or else, you will find yourself where you do supposed to find yourself. There's another pastor again that is a devilish pastor. I'm showing you this, and I'm announcing this so that you can run away from them. Whenever they are preaching, do even listen to them. You will never hear them preaching holiness. Never. You can never hear them. Never. All they preach is prophecy, miracles, signs, and wonder. And that's why many people are deceived by who they follow. They are deceived. Another prophet I want to mention is Prophet Angel Hubbard. Prophet Angel Hubbard. This is the man. He is also pure in prophecy. He can prophesy. This man. He can prophesy well. And when he prophesies, the prophecy is going to be accurate. In fact, his son has even taken his shoe now. His son has taken his shoe too. These kind of prophets are not prophets you should follow at all. They are devilish prophets. If you follow them, I'm so sorry to tell you this, you will land in hell. This is the same pastor. I think this is his wife. See the way his wife tinted his ear. I hear. Can you see? And these are the pastors you are listening to. You are following them on YouTube. You are following them on Facebook. You are following them on Twitter. You are following them everywhere. You listen to their message. Right on, Pastor, Papa, Major One, King. You call them different kind of name. When they pray, you say, I receive. You are receiving calls. When they pray and you say you receive, you are receiving coming out of the darkness. When they pray and you say you are receiving, you are receiving demonic atmosphere in your life. That is why, let me tell you something. All these prophets you see, even merely watching them alone and believing what they are doing, it will put you in bondage. There's no way you can do it. It will what? It will put you in bondage. They went to deep, this man and this major one, the first one I showed, they are both in the same carcass and the same cottage. It is what the Lord has shown to me, told me. They are the same cottage and in the same carcass. By debt, by different things, they live a luxurious life. anyway, they have their life to waste. But I'm warning those who are watching them that run away from these pastors. They are devilish pastors. They are what? They are devilish pastors. Run away from them. I know most of you are listening to them. That's why I'm telling you this, so that you too can be very careful of who you follow. Or else you will just see yourself landed where you do supposed to land. Yeah. I pray you will not land where it is not good. But one thing God will ever do, nobody will blame for God for anything. Now he has shown you now. He has told you who they are. The demonic power they are into. He has told you already the demonic power they are what? They are into. I am telling you today that you learn from what I'm telling you. Run away from them. Don't listen to them. Don't hear them. If anybody, any of your family is going to their church, don't allow them to go there. Another pastor, this one is from Nigeria. I think I mentioned his name recently when I was in program with Evangelist Awusi in Ghana. I mentioned his name. His name is called, and when I mention his name, there's a prophet that said, he's a worker in the church. That apostle, I know his father before, a long time ago. His father is a holiness pastor. And that prophet told me that, sir, when I was just coming in Christ, I went to church, this prophet I want to mention, and I went there. This is what the Lord showed me. I said, what? I said, truly, this is what the Lord told me too about him. The name of the prophet I want to mention is called Prophet Jeremiah Omoto. This prophet. If you must run for your life, this number one, but you must run for your life. Hey! This prophet, if you must run, run where? If you want to run, run where? I'm talking to everybody. I know this message will go and people might want to condemn me by saying this, but I don't care. I don't care. I am doing what the Lord has sent me to do. I am preaching what the Lord has asked me to preach. I am saying what the Lord has asked me to say. I don't care what you say. What I care about is what God will tell me at the end. What the Lord will tell me at the end when I come home. When I stand before the judgment throne and they say, Peter, how is your life? That's what I care about. I didn't care about whatsoever you want to say. I will tell you the truth, the whole truth. This pastor is a giver, but he is from the pit of hell. Hear what I say very well. He is from the pit of hell. Even his wife is a married woman. His wife is from a married world. Nothing you can use me to do. I will expose all of you in the name of Jesus. Even his wife is a married world, from the married world. If you look at his church, if you have ever gone to his church before, I've never gone there before anyway, there is a place, I don't know what he called the place, he called it, I don't know, it's a river. Full of river. He used to travel out through that river to his monthly. I don't know. I think to his son. I don't know where his prayer crew. I don't know prayer ground. He has sheep in the church. Remember, he used to go. This woman has went too far. And he has sold the he has marked all his members with 666. I won't lie to you. All his members have collected 666 in the spirit. Their name of his member, including the workers, including his member, their name are written in the marine world. They are written in the pit of hell. This man is a demonic pastor, which you should not even. Oh my God, I pray in the name of Jesus Christ that the Lord will reveal this to you in the name of Jesus. You cannot say amen. Because it's a pastor, Abi, or you are listening to him, you cannot say amen. I pray the Lord will show you the things of the Spirit. Who this man is. I'm begging you, those who have collected money from him, in fact, you have sold your soul. You have sold your destiny. Those who have collected money from him, you have sold your destiny. They are devilish pastors. Don't even for any reason, go to their church. Because if you go to their church, you have entered into a covenant that only God Almighty can save you. No pastor can save you. Only God can save you. Don't step into their church at all. Don't step into their church at all. If you step into their church, I'm so sorry. You need to pass through a powerful deliverance, or else you will find yourself where you do supposed to find yourself. You will find yourself where you do supposed to find yourself. Another pastor I wanted to mention his name. Is this a prophet? Alpha Lukao. This prophet are also, is it all the prophet I'm showing you this morning? They are all in concourse with all together. They are all in the same concourse. They are all in the same concourse. All the prophets you see me that I'm showing you, they are all in the same concourse, the same thing. They are all the same thing. You see, prophet Alpha, maybe it's Lukao, I think something like that. Lukao, they are all in the same concourse. This pastor. And they have a logo they are using. A logo. They have, if you look at their birth logo, you will see that it's something like an eagle. If I could search it and look for it. You will see that it's like an eagle. That's the kind of bird they are all using. The bird of eagle. All of them are the same thing. Are the same thing. They are the same occultic. Occultic group. I'm looking if I could get the picture here and send it to you. I have a video before, but thank you, Jesus. I eventually get it. Thank you, Jesus. Occultic, I don't know their problems. You see that? Can you see? Can you see that? It's loading. We're going to see it now. Occultic. You see the bet? They have the same wristwatch. You see the bet? You see the bet? You see? Do you see this man? This evil man. Opposed to Marshallen, something like that. It's a very, very satanic man. I think he's the one that is using serpent as miracle. Serpent. Snake. I think he's the one. Evil pastors. You see that? These are the people you are following. They are all in the same occultic group. That you don't need to listen to them at all. This is the bed. You see it? In fact, if I would like you to even watch it if possible. Very demonic pastors. They are demonic pastors into same occultic, and you'll be listening to them. You'll be listening to them. Very demonic. Demonic. And you are there, you'll be saying, I receive to their prayers. I receive. Smart it, I receive. Because of their prophecy.
Yo, South Africans have no chill. You mean to tell me that a single bell, AK Mr.
I think
today we're going to be talking about the bells. Things that I don't think I want to say them here on.
I wouldn't like you to watch this because this oneself is exposing somebody's bed. He himself, self, is he safe? Is she safe? You see?
You know, men of God actually wear the belt. Some people are actually saying that, well, why is it that only people that actually perform miracles in their churches are wearing this belt? This belt has to have something.
Satanic bet. All worship satanic bet. Anything satan. All of them are the same cancer.
So you guys, throw money of what this bell.
The black people. This bet is called Stefano. Stefano Ricci. Cost around.
Stefano Ricci. Cost around
38K. It got nothing to do with God or Illuminati. It is for rich people. Me and you know nothing about it because we haven't targeted, you see. Afford it not. I don't believe this. I think this one is trying to protect them. That's why I said we do need to, you see, a bird that is having South African in fear, you see. You see? They have to do a video to protect their image.
8K. It got nothing to do with cult or Illuminati.
If you look at the lady's face first, see, look at the face. See the woman that is talking. You see how she look like? The woman that is trying to protect. See how she look like? A demonic woman. I pray you will not end in hell in Jesus' name. I pray you will not end in hell in Jesus' name. I pray you will not end in Jesus' name. So, what I want you to know is this. These things are satanic and occultic. 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 They are occultic people. Now, let me show you another means of a prophet that is also occultic. There's another prophet. His name is called Obufu or something like that. It's called Obufu. This pastor he went ahead to go and join. He became a chieftain something. Very occultic man. He's in Ghana. Very occultic. He's in Ghana. He's very occultic guy. This one we're not sure. Let me show you another one. A occultic guy. You ought to be very careful of who you pray. You pray in their church. You have to be very, very careful. Most of these people are in Illuminati. Most of these people are into cultists. Most of these people are people you should be afraid. You should run away from. Don't even go to their church. This prophet. Prophet Obo, or something like that, Obo, Ghana, These people are demonic. They are occultic. Don't try at all to even say amen to their prayer or even listen to them. There's another one. That is one of the most dangerous of all. Prophet Angel, Daniel Obinim. Prophet Angel Obinim. This one has caused atrocity in the church. Big atrocities. He has caused many problems in the church. Many problems. He has caused it in the church. That's why you have to be very careful of who you follow. Very careful of them. Of course, a serious atrocity in the church. And you still be saying amen to their prayers. The Lord is showing you this. And he's asking me to show you because you don't want, at the end of the day, you will not have no excuse to say, sir, but I did not hear this. I did not hear that. Yeah? You will not have excuse. Prophet Angel Obini, or something like that. He a devilish pastor. They are very devilish pastor. This is the pastor. Can you see the pastor? Can you see him? Very devilish pastor. Causing different things in the church. And you are listening to them. They are to be avoided, run away from this kind of people. They are into serious cultism. There's two people more that I wanted to show you. which you have to run away from them completely. I'm showing you so that you can know this. You can know who to follow, who to listen to. There are two people more I want to show you. A woman. This woman, in fact, is serious. I know you know her very well. You must have been listening to her. She's from a marine world. She's from a marine world. Her name is called Prophetess Lucy Natasha. Prophetess Lucy Natasha. A woman you should not even listen to her at all. See the woman. Can you see her? See how she dressed? Prophetess Lucy Natasha. If you are in the spirit, even if you can look at him, you will know who she is. Don't listen to these people. Don't say amen to their prayers. If you say amen to them, it's as if you are putting yourself in bondage. Prophetess Lucy Natasha. Then the last one I'm going to show you is from Nigeria. It's from Nigeria. It's well known in Nigeria. People did not know who he is. One of the satanic pastors in Nigeria. Satanic pastor. His name is Prophet Joshua Igela. Prophet Joshua Igela. I know you might have been listening to him. Prophet Joshua Igela. Yeah? I know you know him very well. You people who are from Nigeria, they know him very well. This pastor is nothing but the but in fact, he has gone extra mile. I have a member then in my church. She's working with him before. She came to me and confessed many things to me. Prophet Igela. Many glory have been taken away by this prophet. Very dangerous. Very dangerous man. I pray you will not go to hell in Jesus' name. For now, these are only few people I'm going to mention their name. But I want to tell you something. You know, I'm shouting now. It's as if this pastor said, why are you exposing other pastors? Why are you speaking against other pastors? To you, I'm speaking to against other pastors. But I am telling you. I am telling you now. I am telling you. It's as if what I'm saying is too much. Pastor, why are you doing this and that? I am telling you the truth now. This pastor, run away from there. Do you know that the bondage of being under a fake pastor is the most worst estate bondage on earth? Because for you to be set free, it will be hard. It takes the grace of God for you to be free. Many of the members are being under the water. They are agents of the darkness for the end time. Agent of the darkness for the end time. I pray the Lord will help you in Jesus' name. If you have blessed them, you have sold your money to their ministry, I'm begging you, go and start asking for mercy. Go and start asking for mercy. It's as if helping the work of the devil to to be forward. I pray God will help you in Jesus' name. I have warned you, My name will be Apostle Peter Daniel from Nigeria. This is Heaven and Hell Live program. You can subscribe to my channel if this helps you. If you feel like this one is helping you, you can subscribe to my channel or even join us on Zoom. I pray the Lord God will help you in Jesus' name. The truth must be said, whether you like it or not. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. It is where we teach Jesus. And I pray for all of you that by one means or the other, you have entered into a covenant of these pastors. I pray by the name of Jesus Christ that the Lord set you free today in Jesus' name. And listen to me very well. These are not all of them, only few of them. I was able to mention only about eight of them. There are many. As the Lord is showing me and telling me who they are, I will also be telling you here. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you, Jesus' name. You will not fail and you will not go to hell in Jesus' name. Thank you. Bye-bye. Bye.